sponsored it as we were celebrating or remembering 9/11. Was brought to my attention that a 1959 graduate of Wofford College was on the plane that hit the Pentagon. And they identified him by his class rank. It was James and Mary Trenton Knight. Amen. So we all connected in some way to these tragedies that are happening all around the world. But we thank God that He is a great God and He's great to be praised. How many thank God for that? I want to ask those that are in the sanctuary, amen, this morning, that you pray over this oil, amen, that it'll do what it is intended to do as it goes forward in the name of Jesus. Because we believe that as it all flows, that God is still blessing. How many believe God is still blessing? Amen. You all come. The elders will come. Amen. You all pray with us. Heavenly Father, we thank you for this oil. We thank you, Lord God, for anointing it. That as we anoint people, Lord God, even as we anoint situations and things, Lord God, that your will and your work will be done. Because it represents now, Lord God, this day, the fire, the Holy Ghost, and your anointing. It is in the mighty name of Jesus that we pray and we count it done for the sake of God Almighty and for the work of the saints, so that if I'm in the church, we thank God for it in Jesus' name. Come on, somebody say amen. Somebody say amen again. Say amen. We stand with you, give God the praise up in the sanctuary. Give God the praise up in the sanctuary. Because God is a great God. God is a mighty God. God is an awesome God. God is a mighty God. And I'm so glad that I made him my God. He made his your God. He made his your God. And we thank God for everything that's been said and done at this point. I'm going to turn the services over in the hands of our MC for the morning. Good morning, our master of ceremonies, none other than our very own Dr. Arthur L. Bruton. For the speech today, give the doctor, give the elder a round of applause, please. Good morning, please. Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord, saints. Praise the Lord again. We thank God for this day. We thank him for allowing us to be here to celebrate the men of the church, the men of God around this state, this city, community, nation. Because God is looking for a few good men who want to work, who want to spread the word of salvation. Time is drawing near, and we cannot tarry, for we know not the hour that he is scheduled to come. And we want our lamps to be filled with oil,
oh, yes,
so that when he does come, we'll be able to get into the party with him and move on to glory in heaven. Again, we thank each of you for these Men's Day ceremonies, for the men of the church, for all the worshipers, for those who are assembled here to hear the word of God.
Yes.
And as I watched yesterday, as various networks and news media recounted a 9/11 tragedy, I thought of where I was during 9/11, and I know that some of you can pinpoint exactly where you were when those twin towers were hit by those planes. But then I thought about how good God has been all yet to each of us. And as I lay last night before I nodded off, I wrote this verse. I too sing America. Stars, stripes, red, white, blue. I too sing America, her freedoms and loving care. For all people who swear to call her their beloved home, be ye weak or be ye strong. This is America, and so many long to be under her cover and cherish freedom like no other. Through travail, attack, heresy, I sing America. For those who defend us fearlessly, I too sing in
the empire.
As we move forward with our program, we call Brother Tommy, TJ Swindler, around for our announcement. Give the TJ a round of applause. Now it's time for us to give to God. And I know that many of you are working all week in this moment. So as you get your tithes and your offerings together, please remember what God has done for you. How he has been there for you when your friends and companions deserted you. We want to give. I want to thank all of those who have been giving during these turbulent times. For those online listeners, those on the conference line, thank you for your tithes and your offering, because you allow the ministry of Jesus Christ to continue over the airways, and we want God to bless you as we know that he will. You're reminded of the pastor's appreciation of Bishop Burgess and his family on the second Sunday in November, and if there's an obligation, you know what your obligation is, please make sure that you take care of that. Let us pray, gracious, most heavenly Father, we thank you for the opportunity that you have presented to us to come forth in this house of God to give you honor, glory, and to lift up your holy name. Oh God, we thank you for all of your blessings upon us. We thank you for our families, and we thank you for your protection. We thank you for your grace and your mercy this morning. We thank you for your son, Jesus Christ, and his salvation. We pray that all those within the sound of my voice will be able to come forth and accept you as their personal Savior. And oh God, we thank you for those who are about to bring their tithe and their offering to the storehouse. And we ask a special blessing upon them this day. Oh Lord, open up the windows of heaven and pour them out a blessing that their storehouse would run over, and they would bring it back to you so that we might tell others about your grace and your mercy. And oh God, as we move forward in these turbulent days, we ask for blessings upon those who care for the sick, upon those who care for the elderly, those who protect us in our communities, in our nation, and around the world. We ask that your veil of protection be upon them. And oh God, we can't thank you enough for this day and for your many blessings and for the things you continue to do for us in spite of our straying away from your word.
pray that you will continue to bless us. In the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. If you would stand and please follow the direction of your.
Praise the Lord.
Now for a poem by Brother David Nesbitt, followed by a skit. brother Tony.
Is it Ann Sunday?
Yes, we can know why we celebrate.
No.
Well, it's because of men like it. Pretty strong. No, seriously. We celebrate to celebrate the contributes our men have did, or our boys and men have did to the community, our nation, and our society. It's because of men like Young Gruden and Pastor Burgess that we can live a better life in our society. And men, you know, everything you see here, men have created. men are the people who are holding this country together. Bone to bone, back to back. You know what I'm saying? That's what. It says, love is patient, love is kind, it is not envy, it is not boast, it is not proud, it is not dishonoring others, it is not self-seeking, it is not easily angry, and it is not keeping no record of wrong. You feel me? All right, go ahead. Now, before we leave this stage, we have a couple gifts for Dr. Gary, for Pastor Gary, and Dr. Gruden. You want to give Andre his gift? Okay. Thank you. Thank you.
Praise the Lord, saints. Praise the Lord again. I want to give honor to my Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, to Bishop Burgess, Prophetess Burgess, to Deacon Bruton, to my father, to the Savior of my church, Sister Miller, to all the saints that are here today. Today is Ben's day. Today is a glorious day because we should be giving God some glory.
Oh, yeah.
We have COVID-19 survivors in the church today. We have people that had cancer that survived in the church today.
Oh, yeah.
We have my son who had a horrible accident at work. They said that his foot could be amputated, but through the grace of God, his foot is healing. He didn't have to have a reconstruction surgery like they said. All he had to have was a mouth skin grab to put back on his arm. And a lot of y'all seen the pictures of that foot, and it looked like something on a horrible. But by the grace of God, though Jesus will work it out, he is going to be able to go home very soon. Because God is good, and if you turn it over to the Lord, he will work it out. See, y'all don't understand, it's a privilege for me to be up here today. Because, you know, I should be up here because, you know, I'm not worthy to do God's work. But you see, God can call anybody. Spoke to a good ass, he can speak through me. If he spoke through rocks, he can speak through me. If he spoke to the backbiters, to the idolaters, he can also speak to me. So I'm here today to give you the word of God, that you want to come with the word of God as he gave it to me. So don't look at me as a man. Then be a sign. Think of me as a messenger from my Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Because Jesus, he has worked it out. He's worked it out for me. He's worked it out for you. And he's going to continue to work it out for you. He's going to continue to work it out for you. So let's give God the praise. You see, these are troubling days. A lot of it is going on in 2020 and 2021. See, we have to deal with Mr. 45. We've had to deal with COVID-19. We've had to deal with social injustice and a lot more in America. You see, the United States and the world have been in chaos. And it's not getting any better. Now we have people wanting to tote guns around like it's the Wild Wild West. We have people that don't want to take the COVID-19 vaccination for whatever reason. I don't know, because I tell you, I didn't turn into no monkey, no ape. And I still haven't fall off my body. So I'm pretty good now. See, things going on in the world, and it is not getting any better. But not only have things been bad in the world, things are getting bad in the church. You see, today church folk have become people without faith. Church folk have lost faith. Christians supposed to be people of faith. Believers that Jesus Christ lived and that he died for you. Instead, it seems like we have no faith. That we don't believe anymore. We have begun to turn from Christ instead of turning to Christ. We have begun to go after the world instead of after God. You see, the church is no longer a place of praising God, a place to give God the glory, a place to assemble together on and worship God. It has become a place of fun, a place to have a good time, a place to party, to gossip, to socialize, instead of a house of prayer. See, the Bible says that people will become lovers of pleasure more than lovers of God. We must end this non-faith in the church and get back to that old-time religion. When we were fasting, when we were praying, when we had prayer meetings at each other's home, when we went to church to actually hear the word of God and not the choir. We need to get back to serving our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Get back to spreading the good news that Jesus Christ lives, and do what started with, and it starts with me, and it starts with you. It starts with everyone on Facebook, everyone on the conference line. You see, Mark 4:40 says, and he said unto them, why are ye so fearful? How is it that ye have no faith? You see, my topic today is going to be take the job.
Take the job.
Telling everyone about Jesus Christ in 2021.
My Lord.
Take the job tell everyone about Jesus Christ in 2021. My scripture text is going to be Mark 16, 5 through 16. And he said unto them, go ye into all the world and preach the gospel to every creature. He that believeth and is baptized shall be saved, but he that believeth not shall be damned.
Yeah.
You see, there are a lot of people out there that have been called to do a work for Christ.
My God.
But we will not, or at least haven't taken the job. I don't know why. We just have not accepted the task that God has given us.
My God.
You see, God don't care about fear. He said in his words, he did not give you the spirit of fear. You see, God don't care about your lifestyle in the past. He is looking for a willing vessel to use so his word can move forward. So his word can be spread throughout the world. Isaiah 6:8 says, also I hear the voice of the Lord saying, whom shall I send? And who will go for us? They said, I'm here. Here am I. Send me. Now, a lot of us, we hear the voice of the Lord, but we kind of ignore it. You see, if you're a true child of God, then you know God's voice. Just as Nathan knows Bishop Burris's voice. Just as DJ knows Sister Candy's voice. Just like Rakisha knows Sister Alana's voice. Sister Miller Neighbor's voice. You see, I have heard Dr. Brood and Bishop Burgess used on multiple occasions that they're saying they're not getting any younger. And that they are trying to pave the way for the next generation to take over the house of God. This place of faith. But we have continued to drop the ball. No one has stepped up. No one has moved forward. No one has taken the job. Now, some of us, we might do a little of this, do a little bit of that in the church, but we have not dedicated all of ourselves to the work of Christ. But you see, God told me that that's what you call a part-time Christian. I don't want nobody mad at me, but part-time Christian. You see, when you go to a temp service, they ask you, you want part-time or full-time? Part-time meaning when you go to work, you only work half the time. You don't worry about the other half because you're probably at home sleeping, watching the game, doing whatever you want to do. A full-time worker is somebody who works full-time, who works the full 40 hours, and who's there doing all the work that needs to be done. You see, in order for the church, especially this church, Universal Body of Christ Church of the Redeemed, to move forward, we need to become full-time Christians and not part-time Christians. And we need to take the job telling everyone about Jesus Christ in 2021. You see, a full-time Christian is a Christian that totally committed to God. A person who will pray and pray for others. A person who will fast. A person who will study the word of God. A person who will give their all to the Lord. Their time, their money, their body, their heart, and their soul. A person who is not afraid to spread the gospel of Jesus Christ. But you see, the problem is, with all that is going on today, church folk are scared. Churches are still closed. People are sitting at home doing nothing. For Christ, there is no faith that God will take care of you during this time of need. Hebrews 11:6 says, but without faith it is impossible to please God, for he that cometh to God must believe that he is, and that he is a reward of them that seek him diligently. See, we must have faith. We need to stop being scared and begin to do God's work. Taking a job, telling everyone about Jesus Christ in 2021. You see, church folks will go everywhere but to church. You see them at Walmart shopping. I guess Walmart is immune to COVID-19. You see church folks at restaurants eating, having a good time. I guess those establishments are immune to COVID-19. You see church folks everywhere but the church. You have kids back in school. Churches are still closed and no one is showing up. You see, people are back to work, but churches are closed and people are not showing up. You have people at every establishment of pleasure, but churches are closed or people are not showing up. And I'm talking about church folk, Christians, Holy Ghost filled, fire about tired of folks going everywhere but the church. You see, the world has moved forward, but the church, the place of faith, is still sitting on our hands and our knees. Not doing the thing that God has told us to do. But you see, it's time for Christians to put away that fear, get up and begin to move the church forward. It's time for us to take that job telling everyone about Jesus Christ in 2021. You see, 1 Peter 2 and 9 says, ye are a chosen generation, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a
for his name's sake.
God is asking us to go tell someone about him. We clam up. And if we are going to, like we're going to be beheaded. Like we're going to be beaten or stoned to death as his disciples was, that put their lives on the line to tell each creature about our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. And we won't even take the time to tell our family members. His disciples knew they was going to kill, preaching and teaching about Jesus Christ. And we won't even tell our neighbor, our co-worker, our friend, or anyone about Jesus Christ. We have forgotten where God has brought us from. We have forgotten what God has done for us. We are ashamed to tell people about what we have been through. Ashamed about what we have done and how God saved us. We want everyone to think that we are perfect Christians. Never committed any sin. When in fact, a lot of us is the worst sinners that have ever been. You see, we have done wrong, but by the grace of God, he picked you up, he turned you around, and he placed your feet on a solid ground. You see, God didn't save you to keep it to yourself or myself. Jesus didn't die for you and me not to tell someone about the goodness of Jesus and all that he has done for you and me. We should be yelling from the rooftop. You should be proud telling everyone about what God has done for you. Mark 8:38 says, whosoever therefore shall be ashamed of me and of my word, in this adulterous and sinful generation, of him also shall I be son of man be ashamed when he cometh in the glory of his Father with the holy angels. Take the job. Telling everyone about Jesus Christ in 2021. You see, there are no perfect Christians. We all fall short. But you see, God used Rahab the harlot. You see, God used Paul the murderer. You see, God used Abraham the idolater. You see, God used William Shalom Burgess the whoremonger, the partier, the club hopper. But he's still using me. And God wants to use you to tell people about how you was on drugs, but God saved you. God wants you to tell people about how you was a whoremonger in the lookout house, at the club, doing everything you thought you was wrong to do. You see, God wants you to tell people about how he saved you from a sin sick soul. God wants you to tell people about how you wanted to commit suicide, how you was depressed and wanted to die, how you was sick and thought you was going to die. But God healed your body and God gave you a reason to continue to live. See, God wants you to tell people about how he brought you out of the world of sin and he kept you from being burnt from a burning hell. See, we need to tell everybody about what we've been through. We need to tell everybody about what we have done, because you never know who you might meet. You might save a life. You might save someone's soul. See, it's time for Christians to stand up and be proud and take the job telling everyone about Jesus Christ in 2021. Because if you don't want to do it, then when you get to those pearly gates and you not have done what God has told you to do, because all your money, all your education, all your good living, all your good looks won't get you into heaven. But if you trust and believe in Jesus Christ, what you got to worry about? If you do the work of Jesus Christ, you will be all right. You see, because I'm ready to get to the pearly gates, and I can't wait to hear those words. Well done. Well done. Well done, my goodness. Thank you, son. Because I want to see his face in heaven. The universal body of Christ, just to redeem. It is time for us to take the job telling everyone about Jesus Christ in 2021. Because God has done so much for you. But you see, it's not only time for us to do it. It doesn't matter if you're white. It doesn't matter if you're black. It doesn't matter if you're Hispanic, Asian, or Italian. We all are children of God, which means we are all part of one body, which means it's time for us all to come together. You see, it's time for those my prayer Baptist church to come together with the universal body of Christ, church of the redeemed. You see, it's time for covenant church to come together with us, brother Baptist church, to do good. glory of God. It's time for Inner First Baptist to come together with Bible Way to do the work of God. It is time for Liberty to come together with Fox Road to do the work of God. Because God don't care if you're Hispanic. He don't care if your race, color, creed. God just wants you to begin to do His work, taking the job in 2021. See, it's time for us to stop sitting in these pews, get outside these walls, and tell somebody what God has done for you. Because God is for all of us, a mighty long way. Jesus Christ died for your sins. He went down into the pits of hell and came back so you wouldn't have to. So I don't know why you still sit on your tail, not giving God the praise, not giving God the glory, because God has done it all for you, and God has done it all for me, and Jesus is still working out for the good of me. Jesus is still working out for the good of the universe. Body of Christ comes to me. Jesus is still working out for all of you in the world. You just need to let your light shine, and let your light shine bright. Because if you drive your car in the dark, your headlights are lost, ain't nobody see you, and you might become crazy. But if you got that light on, everybody sees you coming, and you're gonna be alright. So it's time for you to cut that light switch in your life, and let that light shine so everyone can see, hey, that is the child of God, hey, that is the child of God, hey, that is the child of God. It's time for us to stop hiding, it's time for us to stop running, it's time for us to take the job that God has called you to do, telling everyone about Jesus Christ in 2021. Let's give God the praise.
Sin that has been a covering. covering is the blood of Christ. Someone said, well, what if I did this? It's covered. What if I did that? It's covered. If you'll give your heart to the Lord, if you'll give your life to Jesus. So there may be one, there may be someone in this sanctuary, someone on Facebook, someone on the conference who would like to give their heart to the Lord. This is your time. This is your opportunity. So we're waiting. Jesus is waiting. He said, now is the time. Now is the moment. Heavenly Father, we thank you. But we've done as you have asked us to do. How can you hear without a preacher? How can you preach except he be sent? So the word of God is going forward. And if anyone who has heard who have not given their life to you, it's on them at this point. We thank you. We thank you for letting the people who have given life to you. You said we can believe in our heart that Jesus is the Son of God and that you raised him from the dead. The same shall be saved. And we believe that. So for that individual that has given their life to you this morning, we continue to pray that they'll find a pastor, her, him, believe in the scriptures. We can show them the way to go. Now they're near this place, 8800 Aspen Highway, Bowling Springs, South Carolina. We invite them here for this one's service. Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Might be one who would like to join the church if you're online. We have a way for you to join online to go on our Facebook page. We'll get with you. That one in the building that would like to come and join the church. Take the job. This is your time. It's your opportunity to do such right now. Again, we just want to thank God for everyone that's here, that maybe those who are civil to prayer. I saw and I see Brother Quaylen walked in this morning, and I told his mother, I said, I thought he was going to be Chloe. Then I got like the old quote, prayer really works, don't it? Amen. Amen. God is good. Oh, God is good. Folk want to turn prayer and miracles into some type of nuance, new world type stuff. But I tell folk, we've been praying a long time, God has asked to pray. Our fathers and mothers have prayed before we start praying, God has asked to pray. Isn't it amazing how folk think something new? They want to tell you new stuff about what God is doing. How many know what God is doing? And you want to tell me, baby, sit down, let me tell you something. But in order not to start an argument, you just don't say anything. Because there's no need to argue about the Word of God. And I was telling Deacon Sean about his son, Julius. I said, I really don't care how you feel, but I've just been praying that God will save that foot. And he goes home, he didn't tell his mother, don't baby him, make him get up, make him move around. Because health requires movement. Is that right, Nurse Kim? Is that the right, Nurse April? Health requires movement. Amen. You just can't sit around because death will catch you. Bad things will catch you sitting around. As I say, people say, well, you get older, you just slow down. Why don't I slow down now? Amen. When death comes, I'm going to be in full stride. They say, he was taking a step and he stopped him. God is good. God is mighty. God is everlasting. We thank God for everything in this time. Because we know that prayer works.
Father God, Father God, Jesus, touch Lord God, heal God, Father, in the holy name of Jesus.
Yes, Lord.
Amen. Thank you, Lord.
Amen. Thank you. How are you going to worship him? Oh, I'm so happy to see all of you in church this morning. I look over and see Sister. Kim and I just get really excited and smile. I tell you, those kingdom women, they all look alike. Amen. We thank God. We just thank God for all of you. Brother and Sister Wilkins. So who's that young lady with him every Sunday? I'm getting that's her granddaughter. She's also in the baby family.
Amen.
Looking good. God is good, eh? Worship. So happy to see you. These men that we just spent this morning. They have been called and they took the job. They're going to get better and better and better. Thank God. David, Bill, TJ, Ray. But David, worship. How many worship him? God is good. I'm happy. See Trey and Skylar's mom with this morning. God is good. Yes, Lord God. Desires to destroy us, but we're going to stand.
Thank you.
Jesus.
God, let the anointing of your spirit, God, place heaven, Lord God. Lord God, we see God in this, Lord God, that we hold the throne, Lord God. And Lord God, we give it up to you, Jesus' name. Lord God, give it to you as a of your presence, God. We try to cast that down in the name of Jesus, God. We pray that the sun may be in the sun, God. Lord God, we are losing the light of God with the word, God. Lord, let me speak the same. God, we ask you to bless us all, Lord God. You know that live within, God. Lord God, for real, Lord God. Father God, I pray that you will work on every house, God. You will continue to bring healing, Lord God. You will give us mind, Lord God. You will give us spirit, God.
One of you for being word. Everyone is here in the name of Jesus, God is forgive. Amen. Amen. Sister Cynthia, let's stand here. God said, this place may be life, but sometimes things come, don't know that. Amen. Amen. Just pray. I know you keep on praying. Amen. God is good. His mercy to us and truth to all generations. We thank God for you. We're going to recognize Dr. Fruit. Amen. We close such a fine, blessed men's day together. It was a blessing. We can work one with the other and go forward. But I tell you, my brother, Deacon and Elder William Wilkins, look at your wife and look at the church, particularly your wife. I realize God has brought us full circle. And God is really blessing us. Amen. Amen. It's just a good thing. Amen. If I run, I'm running for a reason. If I jump, I'm jumping for a reason. Put your hands together. Stand on your feet. Amen. That's the greatest thing to pass. Come, everybody, stand on your feet. Amen. And give them remarks. Amen. Our very own doctor.
You can stand where you are. I won't be long. We praise God for this Men's Day celebration. All those who participated on the program, God bless you. We thank you. Thank you for the gifts. We thank you for the word that Deacon Son brought to replenish our souls. Thank you. We praise God for each of you, who are on the Facebook live stream and the conference line. We pray that God will truly bless you and your household now and forevermore. And we do appreciate your support. And we thank God for the angels of mercy that have surrounded each and every one of us. And we pray that they will continue to guide us even until the ends of the world. Uplift your hands to God. Heavenly Father, we thank you as you're prepared to lead, as you're prepared to go forward to see the next part of when I rose this morning. We thank you, Lord God, for what you've done for us and what you've done on our behalf. We thank you for every listener on Facebook, everyone on the conference line. Let them, Lord God, praise you. Let them give to the work here at the Universal Body of Christ as well. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. I'm going to go.
God.